interact with this thing.
I'm ready.
Is this another Phobit? Sweet. Oh, I like it zoomed in like that. It goes back and forth.
I'm ready.
It closes something. You know? I'm ready. Wondering... I know, I'm just going back and forth. I wonder if there was a... Yeah. Because I really don't trust these guys. See, this looks permanent, maybe. But this looks like one that could retract. So if we can ever close up one behind us, we could keep these guys from following, if that ever does happen.
Allow me.
Yes, allow me. So we'll check out whatever the hell this thing is.
Yes, now.
This crystalline structure is distinct from all the others. It looks older, more fundamental, but by no means basic. It is one of the more complex structures you've seen in this place. Large portions of it glow, emitting a low, rumbling hum that you can feel in your chest. Blurry lights flit across the surface of its largest gems. Are you a Phobit? A wave of force pulses out from the crystalline structure. Your body shudders with the impact, even though you hear nothing. Is that a no? Can you speak? The crystals release another single pulse, jolting your body. You get the strong impression that the pulse means yes. Okay, then the other one was yes. Because now it says, this Phobit is not like any other you've seen. It may not have the communicative qualities of the speaker, but it is trying to talk to you nonetheless. What is your function? The glow dims slightly, and the blurry lights on the gem surfaces disappear. You realize they weren't lights at all, but images the Phobit was trying to show you. When they reappear, they show a flat, crystalline plane. Then, one by one, shards emerge. They bud and sprout in the shape of the other Phobits. As you watch, they continue growing, creating ridges, walkways, stairs. In one corner, you see the speaker flower out of the crystals. So this is what it does? Images. In a matter of seconds, this entire region of the Ascension has taken shape in the image before you. This Phobit built it all. Huh. Tell me again. The images in the gem surfaces change, showing a flat crystalline plane. Shards emerge, budding and sprouting into the shapes of Phobits. Ridges, walkways, stairs. In one corner, you see the speaker flower out of the crystals. The images show this entire region of the Ascension created by this Phobit. I'm looking for a circlet of dark hyaline material, the magmatic annulet. Have you seen it? The large crystal pulses once. An image appears of a human figure walking through the Ascension into a cave. The details are too fuzzy to make out who it is, but presumably he has the annulet. After a while, he leaves the cave. The images move quickly then, crystals growing and shrinking as time passes. Suddenly, the entire image shakes, and the cave entrance is gone. Hmm. When the cave entrance closes, it doesn't look like a simple collapse. Crystals grow up from the ground as if they're intentionally blocking the way inside. Why did the cave close? The violet light dims for a moment, and an ominous pulse shudders through your body. An image appears of some kind of multi-legged clawed creature you've never seen before. Show me the creature in the cave again. The violet light dims again. The Phobit shows you an image of a multi-legged clawed creature. It appears to be devouring solid crystal shards. Okay, so it's definitely not a Styka, or Stykas, because we've seen them before. And the Styka doesn't eat crystal or rock. It creates, like, vibrations in rock, and it feeds on those somehow. You closed the cave, didn't you? Can you open it again for me? The light within the crystals freezes in place, and the humming of the phobit ceases. It stays motionless for some time. Finally, you feel the single pulse of force through your body. Yes. Whoa. You feel the ground rumble under your feet. After a few moments, the vibrations cease, and the phobit shows you an image of the cave. The crystals that block the entrance are gone. Huh. Well, farewell. You feel two quick pulses through your body, then the crystal structure goes still. Interesting. So it's nice to be in this place, which is... Is that... Well, that's the speaker. That's the encampment. That's the builder. We just spoke to the builder. There's the crystalline cavern that we need to get to. All the way on the other side. So yeah, it's nice to be in this place away from, like, gooky, slimy meat and maw stuff. Okay. So, we go. Let's see if anyone has anything to say about this place.
What's on your mind?
Anything to say about anything. She adores me. Alright. Tiber, anything to talk about?
Yes, lass.
Not yet. Okay, we're done. Thought they might have something to, you know, say about this place.
Naturally.
On it.
So nothing to see here then.
I'm going.
We're going. Is that it right there? We'll get there quickly.
All right.
Looks like bones. 38 shins. Those are our bones. Oh, can we go up? That'd be cool. Of course we can go up. Cool, right there.
I'm ready. I'm always.
All right.
She's in the way. Another 47 shins, nice. We are pretty rich. Just looking around for anything we might have missed. Huh. I wonder if that cave leads up here. Those are the phobits. I like those. Those are cute. Those are cute names, phobits. Alright, back down. Into the crystalline cave. Crystalline cavern.
Hmm. Yes.
What? An actual dungeon? The Indigo Tide. Justice, compromise, and the greater good. That's a pretty good one. This reminds me of, you know, I don't think this reminds me of anything. Well. Who said that? Probably Aretas. Maybe Calisthenes. Crystalline Cavern. Alright.
What's on your mind?
Yes, we've been standing still for too long. Sorry, guys. Just checking.
Yes, lass.
Alright. I'm with you. That's good to hear.
Fine.
Oh, wow.
Naturally.
There's some more canisters or something over here. Another hyper-elutriated force in 37 shins. I wonder if these are randomly generated. I got four of these things? Oh, we got elutriated and hyper-elutriated. Oh, we got three of those. Sweet. The only thing is... so limited with this. Okay. Elutriated and hyper-elutriated. Fleetfoot moss. Cool. I love loot. I love loot.
Yes. It is done.
I wonder if there's any creatures in here.
In an instant.
Dead end, huh? Just making sure.
Gladly.
Oh, hello there. Something interesting over there.
I'm going.
It looks like a futuristic looking chest of some kind. Oh, what's that? Thinker's cap. Cool. Oh, we're gonna get sick. 20 shins. Did I pick that up? It was an artifact, right? Not a cipher. Here it is. Plus one intellect edge. Plus one damage per effort applied to max. Plus six on esoteric. Negative effects are minus two intellect pool. I don't like that. The intersection points of this net of fine filigree is marked by small white gemstones. When placed over the head, the gemstones buzz and shimmer, firing information directly into the mind. This increases the user's intelligence, though the effect can be overwhelming at times. Well, that increases, yeah, I see intellect, edge and stuff, but yeah, overwhelming minus two intellect. I don't know. I've seen a bunch of these things that, like, help with edge, but take away from the main stat, so I don't know how helpful those can really be. Let's give this to Tiber. And I gotta remember to use some of these. Because we're all overloaded except for Calistes. She's next. Gotta use some ciphers next time. Definitely give us an edge. Oh, look at that. There's stuff. That's the way we came in.
Absolutely.
Abso-fraggin-lutely. Neat. Awesomeness.
Why, of course.
I like this place. This device seems to be the source of the low hum that permeates the cavern. It's receiving power through thick cables from two large machines against the wall. Phobit appears to be trapped in the central crystal. It flickers excitedly. Excitedly because it doesn't want to be there, or what? I don't want to interact with anything yet. This machine is similar to the one next to it, but it doesn't have any sort of interface or control panel. You can interact there as well. That looks like a resonance chamber, doesn't it? Well, we got some special kind of force field or something here. I If we can get through this, we can get to the goodies inside. An impenetrable field of energy seals off part of the cave. All kinds of goodies inside. Oh, start messing with machinery.
Yes, now.
All of the cables in the room connect to this bulky machine and its twin. They generate a low rumble that you can feel in your feet. As you approach, a screen lights up. A strange maze-like rune flashes angrily in the center of the screen. Three other glyphs revolve slowly around it in an elliptical orbit. A bolt of lightning, a set of parallel lines, and a circle. Before I touch anything, I can also interact with... I can interact with what? This and this. Let's mess with this.
Yes.
The stasis pod is dull and lifeless. There is no visible way to activate it. Okay, then we're interacting with this.
Of course.
On my way.
The machine continues to rumble softly. Maze-like rune flashes angrily in the center of the screen with three glyphs. I guess we're supposed to touch these glyphs in an order and then touch the rune? I don't know what order though. Touch the flashing maze-like rune. A picture appears. It looks like a technical schematic of the device behind you at the center of the room. The source of the low hum. Vertical lines of runes appear next to the schematic, but you can't read them. Oh, this? This is the source of the hum. Return the interface to the initial screen. Try to decipher the runes. Of course I'm going to use anamnesis, you kidding? I wonder if 100% will ever fail, like randomly or something. Gotta be a real tough thing to figure out, then. Although you can't read the runes, the gist of the message becomes clear. It's a warning about the device with the two crystals at the center of the chamber. The device has deteriorated to an unstable state, and any fluctuation in power is likely to result in an interruption in function. The runes do not say what will happen if the device ceases to function, or if they do, you cannot decipher it. Return the interface to the initial screen. You press a small icon in one corner. The display disappears and is replaced by the flashing maze-like runes surrounding the three revolving glyphs. Okay. So, we've got a lightning, a parallel lines, and circular glyphs. You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna save the game. Because I can. Because I don't know what to press. I always check to make sure it's listed in saves. It's just my thing. So one looks like a lightning bolt. Power, right? One looks like two lines, which makes me think off, and one's a circular ring, which makes me think on, or power. I'm looking for a clue in the surroundings here, but I'm not seeing any indication. I'm guessing we're trying to turn this thing off, though, to get to this stuff. And I'm sure it's in here.
Yes.
They're running all the way up there. Yeah, it's not gonna let us cheat. Touch the glyph that looks like a bolt of lightning. The rune and glyphs disappear, replaced with an image depicting the bank of three large crystals to your right. Symbols flow into the image, showing that the device is currently receiving power from the machine before you. A circular symbol glows next to the image. Each time one of the symbols enters the image of the crystals, the circular symbol pulses brightly. Pressing it would likely cut the flow of power to the bank of crystals. I understand, but I want to see all that there is to see, so this is probably what we want to do. Touch the glyph of parallel lines. An image appears of the pod in the far corner of the room. The image of the pod is dim. A circular symbol sits next to the image. Oh, so we'll get power to it? That's the pod. And then the circular glyph. I'm afraid the circular... Yeah. I'm afraid to touch the circular symbol because that's like this circular symbol. So let's press this. So we can get power to the pod. Both the symbol and the pod light up on the screen. The circular symbol pulses in time with the odd symbols that march into the image of the pod itself. In the far corner of the room, new noises indicate that the pod is now receiving power. Cool. I love it.
As you wish.
That made an awesome, cool sound, and look at it now. Rings of energy pulse around the stasis pod. There appears to be nothing inside it, but a control interface hovers a few centimeters off the circle at one end of the pod. Surprisingly, the words on the interface are written in the truth, and you can understand them. There are several options, but most of them are dimmed out. The only two functioning options are check status and access data. Check status. A picture of the pod appears. The lid on the image is closed and flashing red. Several other places on the image of the pod flash red as well. The text says, Stasis pod empty. Error. Self-diagnostic failed. Cannot open status pod. Primary functions offline. Data integrity 67%. Okay. Access data. A list of records appear. Several of them are crossed out with the word corrupted next to the name. Most of the functioning records are mundane, like system integrity results or a list of lab equipment. But there are a number of functioning dated records labeled experiment notes. You know, those guys from up top, when we leave here, there's a good chance they're going to be waiting for us. And then we're going to have to run across the area and, try to close the bridges so they can't get across. That'd be cool. That's what I would do if I were making this game. Oh, wow. Got all these notes. Cool. Experiment notes. Functioning dated records. Awesome. So this is from the last, not the last cast off, the changing god. These are his notes. They have to be. So exciting. Access the first experiment note. An unfamiliar male voice reverberates throughout the room. Preliminary investigation suggests that Mazoff was correct. The crystals of the Ascension bear the properties we require to complete the resonance chamber. The amulet proved invaluable in reaching this place and may have other uses besides, so it will be some time before I can return it to Dracogen. Much more experimentation is required before I can know for certain whether the Ascension holds what I seek. Now, if we access again, it's just going to be the same exact thing, yeah, so I'm not going to do that anymore. Second experiment note. The secretions of the crystal vor are one of the few substances I've found that can eat through the living crystal of the Ascension. I have had several larvae brought here for that purpose. Dracogen exudes patience with regard to the annulet, but I've dealt with other dracogens before. Other dracogens? He will only remain patient for so long before he decides I have cheated him. No matter, I fear the sorrow more than I fear them. So there's several dracogens. Or they were previous dracogens. Huh. Interesting. I wonder if this dracogen that he's speaking of in the log is the same dracogen we dealt with. Or if that's a prior one. Access the third experiment note. I have several experiments running simultaneously while I wait for the crystal to grow. True to their name, the crystal vores have proven quite adaptable to this environment and invaluable to this part of the process. He's growing a crystal. Right, for use in this. Because the crystal we have... we spoke to whoever it was, a female in the Order of Truth. The crystal had something to do with it. I forget her name. So long ago. The Ascension natives may prove useful as well. I'd ignore them initially, for although their speaker is capable of cogent communication, it has proven useless in providing any real information. However, I have since seen other natives accomplishing some remarkable feats with the crystal itself, so I captured one for study. We shall see if there's more I can learn from it. Imagine reading these out of order. Like, why? Who would ever do that, right? Several of the crystal vor larvae hatched prematurely and escaped. It's unclear how it happened, but I suspect someone came looking for the annulet while I was buying supplies in Sagas. No doubt they tampered with my machines in their effort to find it. To prevent further sabotage, I have placed the annulet and the remaining larvae behind an energy field, right, which we can see across the room there. The power generator can open the field, but it now requires a passcode sequence to ensure there is no further tampering. Huh. Or we can just smash the thing, which Aratus is pretty good at. I am not foolish enough to record that sequence here, but should something happen to me such that I forget, the three geodesics through the barycenter are the key. The three geodesics. Barycenter? The voice says nothing more. If that was supposed to be a hint, its meaning is unclear. Perhaps it would make more sense when looking at the power generator itself. I'm going to write that down. Three? Geodesics through barycenter. For the code. Fifth note. The escaped crystal vores are growing and breeding. They now constitute a serious threat to my work. He pauses. I've built a device to emit sound waves at a very specific frequency, lulling the creatures into dormancy. So far, it appears to be an effective countermeasure, but I shall have to keep careful watch to be sure. I must also make sure that the power generator does not experience any interruptions, lest they wake again. You know, the same thing happened with the Stika. When we emitted, like, sound vibrations, we were able to get past them without fighting any of them through their, the Stika lair, which was right next to the Changing God's, like, I guess, his crossroads? Something like that it's called. Sixth note. The voice speaks between ragged breaths. This will be my last entry. Dracogen's patience has worn thin, as I knew it would. His agents are outside and will no doubt break through my defenses momentarily. If they do, I will have to abandon this body. I don't know when I'll be able to return, but I am... The voice cuts off. There is no more of this entry. I guess then they broke through, but there is a seventh note. The voice on this entry is the same as the other entries, but it has none of the confidence from before. I don't know what's happening. I woke in this cave, surrounded by angry men demanding something called an amulet. I don't know what it is, but they attacked me. I didn't know what to do, so I fought back. I killed them. The blood. It's everywhere. Some of it's mine, but most of it... I found these notes afterwards. When I was trying to figure out what was happening to me, I couldn't figure out how to retrieve the amulet, but those men were sent by someone called Dracogen. I don't know what any of this means. I'm going to find out, but I'm leaving this message in case I don't make it back. I don't know who will listen, but... Well, I figured I should leave something of me in here, somewhere, in case I don't get very far. Yeah, whoever wrote that was a cast-off, because the Changing God obviously abandoned this body, and then a new intelligence filled that brain, and ta-da, he didn't know what the hell was going on. Just like we didn't know what was going on when he abandoned us when we were, like, in orbit or something. Or falling through the sky, re-entry. Interesting. Very interesting. Nothing new there. Crystal Vores, huh? Remarkably like Stika. I wonder if those were his name for the Stika. Or if those were the Stika before they became Stika. You know what I mean?
Yes.
They evolved. I mean, who knows how long ago this was? What if we touch the circular glyph? I do want to do that, but... An image appears depicting the humming device in the center of the room, the one with two crystals. Symbols flow into the image, showing that the device is currently receiving power from the machine before you. A circular symbol pulses each time a symbol flows into the image. Pressing it would likely cut the flow of power to the crystals, causing the humming to cease. The circular symbol is outlined in red, suggesting that the function of this device is particularly important. Right, so that would shut off power. And if we go here... The circular symbol dims, and the symbols freeze in place, no longer marching into the image of the three crystals. To your right, lights on the bank of crystals fade. A phobit blinks and chirps within one of the large crystals, finally freed from its imprisonment. It zips around in the crystal, makes cheerful noises in your direction, then vanishes in a flash of light. Sweet! Machine is powered down and the three crystal chambers are empty. Well, that was nice of us.
Going.
Actually wasn't sure that what that would do. So that's the bolt of lightning, circular glyph. Do I need anamnesis? What if I just press this symbol? The circular symbol dims and the pulsing rhythm of symbols marching into the image cease. The low hum that permeates the cave fades and grows completely silent. Nothing happens for a moment or two. Suddenly, a series of strange popping sounds emanate from the device in the center of the chamber. On the screen, the image of the device begins to flash, and red parallel lines cut through the part where power once flowed into it. Arcs of energy jump over the surface of the device for a few moments, then cease. The cavern becomes eerily quiet. Huh. Oh, crap.